Now, brave friend, your band must enter a charnel house, for here lie the bodies of many dwarven generations. Many were slaughtered by invading orcs that bred and multiplied in warrior's darkness. Now they rule the vast halls and spread through the corridors and mines. But they do not rule warrior. That is the province of another, more powerful being. Tread carefully in the darkness, for you enter a world of enemies. Move swiftly, for if you do not, I shall find you. Very good. You have now entered the long dark of Moria. Moria is a lost civilization that spans many ages. And in the deep places of this world, foul terrors still dwell, filled with wrath and malice. I expect you found the landscape changed since we recently passed through. That was the work of the Watcher in the water. For what good are words of opening, or enchanted doors for that matter, against such ancient powers? Saruman admires the war, the terrible creation that mocks the wolf. To spread terror, he unleashed them upon the lands surrounding Isengard. They are fast and powerful creatures, able to bring down a horse and rider. Few can withstand their attack. There is evidence they invaded Moria, but I avoided their dens. I hope you are as fortunate.
Sometimes the little ones are hardest to kill.
I might resent that remark, but I think you're right.
What have you got there?
It would appear we have discovered the last delving of the dwarves, the great Mithril pit.
And that mine would likely lead us to the other side of the mountain, would it not?
So what do we wait for? Let us follow it!
I see you found your way deep into Moria's Mithril mines. For that was the true wealth of this realm. Hard as dragon scales, but light as a feather. It has no rival in times of war. Some seek it unto death. Some are given it freely. The lands you passed through were built around its trade. Now none dare seek it in these dark halls.
Thank you.
Do not fear as you wander Moria's mazes, for powerful beings such as I are here to aid you. For many long years, I have played the role of a gray wanderer across the lands of Middle-earth. Another, the white wizard Saruman, calls himself the leader of our order. But Saruman chose to see afar, to see all, and in his greed, he became enslaved. We have had, you see, a falling out. And thus his servants have forced our party to skirt Saruman's domain. For he hopes that within Moria, I shall fall to a greater power than even he possesses.
Thank you.
These wretched orcs are trapped within these halls. They hide from the sun, but more do they fear their new master. They awaken him in times of great need, yet always fall victim to his terrible wrath. You have found our campsite. That is very good indeed. You have also found Boromir, for he has traveled with us since Rivendell. Have you considered, Berethor, precisely why you were compelled to seek him?
Many that live deserve death, and some that die deserve life. Do not be too eager to deal out death and judgment. Even the very wise cannot see all ends.
Not only the dwarves have inhabited these mountains, for this huge range divides Middle-earth east from west. Long ago, on the eastern slopes, orcs slew Isildur, the king of Gondor, and have since infested these crags. Other creatures, such as Gollum, also sought refuge here. Now that the northern passes are sealed, scant few inhabit this ghostly realm, save for goblins.
Listen!
What is this?
Wait. I see something. What do you say to this dwarf?
That would be a key to a very important item. Something kept at the throne room. Perhaps a book of secrets.
Can you lead us there? Time is running out!
I think we have found more than we bargained for.
It is a Balrog of Morgoth.
We must master our fears. Follow that creature. It is our only way out.
It is no use. The path is destroyed. We must fall back and find another way.
Yes, there is a secret way through Moria, but I did not need to search for it, as you must.
Astorbeth! Amen!
I cannot reveal the secrets of the elves. You must learn them yourself. The dwarves designed their defenses so they might emerge from hidden doors and surprise their foes. Let us hope you can open this portal before your enemies surprise you.
Taken the bridge.
and the second hall. We have barred the gates, but cannot hold them for long. The ground shakes. Drums. Drums in the deep. We cannot get out. A shadow moves in the dark. We cannot get out. They are coming. Throw yourself in next time and rid us of your stupidity. breed knows only fear and domination. It does not matter their size. Remember this lesson well, for there are much more powerful orcs upon your road. And some I hope you never encounter. Long have I walked the forgotten paths of Middle-earth, and oft I studied the treasury of their past. Thousands of years ago, elves fought in a last alliance with men, overthrowing the evil of Sauron. But their animosity towards dwarves extends further back in time. None speak of deeds that divided them, but ancient distrust still burns in the heart of both races.
Have you heard nothing Lord Elrond has said? The ring must be destroyed.
And I suppose you think you're the one to do it.
So much for the feeble.
No, I trust an elf.
You witness a rare thing, Gondorian. Elf and dwarf united in uneasy fellowship. But as you travel these lands, your small company faces the same old hatreds. Unite them, for the remaining treasures of Moria will not be surrendered without a fight.
Okay.
graced, my friend, for the Lady of the Light guards and guides you. The elves channel the powers of fire, air, earth, and water, for they are the firstborn. Should you survive Moria, it is likely you will see their realm, despite the evil you carry with you. For many long ages has the Lady Galadriel fought the Shadow, but it has not claimed her. Go now and finish your task. They await you beneath the trees.
Moria's Book of Secrets.
We cannot take it with us.
No, but I shall open it.
Here it is. Andalui Ven. I can speak the words, but I cannot find the door.
Of course not. That would require cunning beyond the mind of an elf. Yes, witch, your people serve to secure our doors and seek our mithril, but you are never the power behind our throne. Then, now, or ever.
Words hold great power to capture the mind, to enrage the heart, But it is things that cut to the heart of the matter.
You cannot die. I see you.
Orcs are a cruel race, their nature shaped by the hatred of the Dark Lord. Destruction and pain are all they know. And in Moria, they have become a small, cruel breed the elves call goblins. I shall tell you more should we survive our current encounter with these creatures.
What do we have here?
Can't you tell by the wrapping of the shaft? It's the last axe ever forged in Moria. A respected ranger.
I'm sorry, my friend. I meant no disrespect.
As you have learned, my friend, dwarves are formidable tunnel fighters. Now, as you behold their shattered armories, you glimpse weapons wielded long in the defense of Moria. Tools and devices of war, large and small, were forged here. Some have been lost, some recently found, but the greatest of all still remains hidden.
Yeah.
have found it, at last.
What is this? Never before have I seen such armor.
It is yours now. In memory of your people.
Aye, in memory of them all.
It is time to find our fellowship, Gondorian. I can no longer hold back the Balrog's gaze. He senses we are here. We must reach Balin's tomb before he does to escape behind us. Hurry!
I believe we are here, Dwarf. No more secrets.
Aye. There through our craft lies the hidden door.
Andalou, Yven.
This road leads to the Great Hall of Records, where we are likely to find yet other secrets.
You now witness the marvels I journeyed through.
Let me risk a little more light.
This is Dwarodelf, of old filled with light and splendor, now merely a goblin hunting ground. Seek the shattered tomb, and beside it a dead troll. Enter more deeply at your own peril.
Thank you.
comes.
The Balrog has found us!
Seek shelter! That creature seeks the wizard! We must reach them first!
You were fortunate and escaped Balin's tomb more easily than we. The goblins swarmed there. We almost lost several to their cave troll. But our fellowship prevailed, and the creature fell. Beware. The goblin horde is relentless. You must stay ahead of them.
This one is easy to track.
He melts the very rock. I have never seen such power.
Here, you lead on, so you may see him first.
Thank you. Cloud is passing.
Now is the time to cut them down!
I wouldn't be too hasty. They're moving above us.
Hold back! They're trying to surround us!
Thank you.
Dark Lord Sauron has enslaved many in his rise to power in Barad-dûr. Long ages ago, the evil of Mordor formed into being the Troll. Another mockery of life. Many of his breed have been enslaved to serve his fell purpose. And now the very Troll that destroyed your dwarven friend Sauron seeks him to finish this grim task.
Thank you.
goblin scum have defaced this place. My lord, I apologize. I shall avenge your honor.
A spy! He is going to warn others!
Grief filleth Nin. Come!
You are close now, Gondorian, about to leave the realm of the dwarf for the world of the elf. But you are of the world of men and can never fully understand elven ways. For long ages, they protected Middle-earth. But their time here ends. They will retire to their final port, and from there, sail out of your history. But there is one whom they trust, and who you will serve in the years to come. Aragorn of the Dunedain will be crowned king, and you are destined to play a role.
this place, creature of shadow. The creature draws power from that altar. He will be difficult to deal with.
Thank you.
drums must be silenced!
We must attack them at range!
And quickly! The longer we wait, the more goblins it shall be called!
Thank you.
This must be a burial house of great honor.
Aye, here lie the lords of Moria.
Carefully. I don't want to join them.
Thank you.
What would be in this sarcophagus?
It is the last of my kin, if you must know. Tomb guards! It's an ambush!
To reveal what I know of your companion, for dwarves share well the stories of their fellows. Your dwarven friend's life is wreathed in sorrow. His sons traveled with Balin to Moria. No mirth did they find there. The goblins slew all his sons, and I fear the trolls devoured them. You will find little warmth in this dwarf. For this dark knowledge turned his heart to stone. In my own journey to Moria, I traveled with another dwarf, Gimli, son of Gloin. I regret you will not behold the nature of dwarves that I experienced. This is the only way to pass through, warrior. The bridge of Khazad-dûm. The dwarves built great defenses here. To approach, you must traverse towering stairs. Exposed to flanking fire from stone galleries. Finally, a narrow choke point to hold invaders while they marshal their defenses. Now you shall behold me, Gondorian. Our journeys merge here. Briefly. This is the only way to pass through, Mori.
Thank you.
I'm still with you, my friend. I see you enter Lothlorien. My companions journeyed through these woods not long ago. They will allow you passage, but know that this is not a gift often granted. You will not enter the heart of their kingdom, merely a brief glimpse of it, so that you might understand. They are elves, immortal, and graced with powers beyond your imagining. While they remain in Middle-earth, they will aid those free people who prove worthy. Begin your journey now, back to the world of men. Bring with you both honor and a pure heart, for to be cleansed, the White City demands it. To do this, you must gather those artifacts of the ages that still contain ancient power. With these, you hold some measure of the elves' past greatness. Become our champion. Face the power of Mordor and help to turn the tide. I know who it is that you seek. Boromir, son of Denethor, has come to their realm, and we have taken his full measure. Others, too, visited these woods. Some have found what they sought, others know what they must do. They have left Lothlorien and journeyed south. But theirs is a long road filled with danger. You fall behind. They have taken the river and passed through hostile lands to the falls of Braros. The elves will grant you and your small company gifts to aid you in your quest. They will guard and guide you to Rohan's plains. If your heart is true, you will find a way to continue on the path they have opened before you.
Company of Uruk-hai passed this way.
What of the party from Rivendell?
It's difficult to tell. Wait. Here.
You should not scout so far ahead. These lands are filled with danger.
Have you been following us?
For many days. Your companion requested it.
Yes. I cannot protect all of you all of the time.
I am perfectly able to defend myself.
I have buried others who spoke those words.
I thank you for your aid. How may I be of service?
We must cleanse these gullies. Help me assemble patrols so we may cut past the rear guard of Uruk-hai.
You need not tarry in this place, for Boromir, eldest son of Denethor, will never reach these lands. He has passed from this world. He traveled in the company of great warriors, but in his heart he desired their overthrow.
Could it be mine? It should be mine! Give it to me!
To his redemption, he fell defending the weakest of them. He was struck down by the Uruk-hai of Saruman, who now roam freely in these lands. The mission you were given has ended. You are free of your burden. Join us in our quest.
Yeah.
Your small group fights well. Find all of my elves, Gondorian, and we shall be strong enough to fight our way out of this maze of rock.
These are perilous times for Eomer, Chief Marshal of the Mark and nephew to King Theoden. He alone challenges the King's advisor, Grima Wormtongue, a base and deceitful tool of Saruman. Through Grima, the White Wizard has captured the mind of the King. And by Theoden's feeble hand, Eomer and his most loyal men have been banished upon pain of death. Still, his riders will not abandon the plains of Rohan. Seek them, for their loyalty lies upon our side, and they will be trusted allies in times of need.
Rohan's warriors must use that cave as an outpost.
It would appear they suffer heavy casualties defending their frontier.
How do we find a way inside?
Deeper in the ravines, we shall find it.
Shepherds must command Fangorn to defend itself. For only they can compel the trees to uproot themselves. For the power of the earth to survive, they must awaken. And should they wake, they must then decide to march to war. Saruman prepares his army. We must prepare ours. Long has the River Anduin flowed from the heart of Middle-earth to the far reaches of Gondor, and long have the elves defended it. kings of Numenor sat upon tall seats of stone, surveying this realm. For across it traveled enemies of both man and elf. Easterlings from Rûm, orcs from Mordor, and now Saruman's Uruk-hai.
Transformed.
Yes, the need is great.
What are you doing here?
At this moment, warning you of orcs ahead. Home of the Horse Lords. The people of the Riddermark are strong and proud. Rohan knows little of the elves, though they do not press them by their presence. At Meadowsend, the court of Edoras, dwelled Theoden, king of Rohan. Do not hope for his welcome, for Saruman has stolen his mind. Long has Rohan been the ally of your kingdom of Gondor, but like their king, the ties grow weak. Saruman prepares war upon Rohan, and it shall come soon. Already he incites the wild men, Rohan's ancient enemies.